pumped up. Colin Palmer here. Let me start off with a little story. First year at Flow, met the Ironman. I don't really know anything yet. You know, I've been away from wrestling. I'm calling one of your matches, and I have you guys mixed up. And so I'm calling like, oh my God, you're like the top seed, maybe the second seed. But I'm like, oh, huge upset. The, you know, this unseeded guy's up by like 12 points. And one of the Moore brothers, number 20, is like, dude, you got the guys mixed up. And I felt like such a dork.
That's awesome.
But it's cool to see you coaching. You're like one of the guys that we were really following, was really followed during those years through high school.
Right.
And here you are, all grown up. Just told me you had a daughter.
Yep.
Now and
18 months old, man.
It's cool. How's the club going? Tell me how you got into
Everything's
this.
Everything's going good. Basically, I got injured at Ohio State. Mm-hmm. I got MRSA in my spine. And from there, I started training some of the elite guys in Columbus.
Uh-huh.
And basically took off with a little training center. And now it's turned into one of the biggest in Ohio.
Thanks. So I want to talk about the club, but real quick, man, when something like that happens to you and your identity is wrestling, you're, you know, I'm sure that's where all your time and effort went. Dang, what was that transition like to,
It wasn't the easiest because obviously all my hopes and goals were to be a few-time national champ, all that good stuff. And to see all my training partners and buddies and, you know, all those guys winning it down the road, it was tough to swallow, but I mean, I'm pretty fortunate, man. It put me in a position where I took off into a different venture, and I love it.
So, besides, you know, it changing your path a little bit, I'm sure you learned, like you grew up or learned from something that's that challenging, right? Or that big of a heartbreak?
Yeah, I mean, basically just learning how to be happy for your guys winning and not being selfish anymore and just focusing on yourself and focusing on yourself winning. That was the biggest adjustment. You know, coming here to the state tournament, watching these guys find success through the coaching and the tools that I was giving to them. It took a couple of years for me to adjust to that because I was so used to myself winning. You know, I only lost, you know, a handful of times in my entire career. So it was tough to swallow. But moving into this and on the coaching aspect of it, you just learn so much. You take every piece that I've been put in from other coaches and tied it all together and pass it off to all my guys.
Yeah. Did you wrestle in the OAC events when you were in junior high? And
yeah, so they started.
This is 15 years old. The other one's 20 years old.
Right. I don't think I did any of the grade schools, but I'm pretty sure the junior high is when it was hot and heavy back then.
Yeah.
So I did 6th, 7th, and 8th grade here.
Yeah, going back and looking at, like, the brackets, you know, eventually so many guys, you look through there, it's like, oh, national champ, All-American, Olympian.
Yep.
What was it like when you were a younger competitor in a tournament like this? How did you approach or feel going into tournaments?
We were a little bit psycho, man. We were raised by Wayne DePayne, and we just had all kinds of craziness on our side. So coming into an event like this, it was just another day in the park, man. We came here, did the best we could, and obviously we were super trained, super strong, and we didn't have much. We didn't have many tight matches.
Nice. So let's get to the club now. You're in the Columbus area.
Correct.
How many guys you got wrestling here?
I think we got 40 guys today.
40 guys?
Yeah.
Thanks. So what's the total club size?
We got about right around 100. We do some split sessions just to get everybody in there.
So basically, all your time goes into your club
100%.
Now then, right?
Yep.
Wow. So tell me about that. What's like a standard week? Obviously, you got practice, but what do you do to prepare for practice, to have the club ready for the guys? You know, there's got to be more to it than what I understand.
Yeah, there's a lot of behind the scenes. I mean, you got to do all the scheduling, all the paperwork, all the waivers, all that good stuff. And basically, you just got to be personable. You got to be able to talk to the parents. You got to be able to deal with situations when they don't go, you know, in the favor you want them to. And you know, obviously in this sport, parents are a little nutty, and it's awesome. I mean, it's part of it. They actually care. You know, the guys that come to me, they care. They want to win. They want to train. So that's what I appreciate about the club that I run. You know, these guys are traveling from an hour and a half, 2 hours away just to come get some practices in. Monday through Thursday. And then, you know, we got guys coming from Kansas, Tennessee, Pennsylvania, to all the camps throughout the spring and summer. So it's good, man.
So it sounds like, you know, the guys going there are pretty tough, but I'm sure, you know, there's guys that you're training there that weren't, you know, didn't understand wrestling like you and have as much success.
Right.
You know, how do you, as somebody that was so dominant, take care of the needs of somebody that's just not on that level?
Honestly, I just, you know, everybody's got their own style. And there's a lot of coaches that, you know, that they'll try and teach their style to every single kid that comes in their room. That's just not the right way to do it. You just got to show the kids the techniques that, you know, all the techniques, you know, and let them figure out their own style. Once they form their own style, then you run with it, you know, and then you just critique that style until they're the best they can possibly be.
Nice. What do you hope that, you know, when you send a kid off, or he's going to high school or even to college, I'm sure you train high school, but what are you hoping that he leaves your system with, or how's he prepared?
Honestly, just being good in all positions is what I look for. We've always been dominant in the top position. I've been putting some more work in with some bottom wrestling and trying to get these guys just an all-around wrestler. So when they get to these other high school coaches or college coaches, they got all aspects covered. Just need a little bit of details here and there pinpointed. And, you know, maybe even some of my guys, they just need, you know, that next level. You know, once I get them to a certain level, they need to jump into the high school world or jump into the college world and figure it out for themselves.
Nice. In terms of, like, your own development as a coach, what do you do to stay on top, keep up with new techniques or new strategies?
I watch a lot of wrestling. I train a lot myself. I coach a lot. I watch a lot of wrestling. I take every piece of advice that I ever get from any of the top dog coaches and just watch what they're doing. You know, some of these coaches, they'll post some videos every now and again of, like, what they got going on in their room. And, you know, any chance you can, pick their brain. You know, pick their brain, see what they're doing, see what they're thinking, and just form a different cycle off of that.
Nice. Who's the best wrestler in the world?
That's tough. I don't know, man.
Who's a handful of guys that you love to watch, or, you know, people that you study?
Honestly, my top four are the guys who, you know, I came up with. Kyle Dake, Jordan Burroughs, David Taylor. I've always loved watching Taylor.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, not bad. But Logan Staber, I mean, all those guys, you know, eventually somewhere along the way you either train with them or you compete against them or whatnot. And, you know, to see those guys as successful as they are, it's awesome.
It's crazy that the talent, the guys that were in your room in high school and then just probably you saw every weekend.
Right.
You know,
yeah.
They were good, what, 2008, you know,
yeah.
But now seeing how many of them are, like, at the next level, winning world medals.
It's crazy.
Or can't make the team because the other one is.
Other.
And then,
yeah.
But it is fun to see. All right, if I'm going to start a club next week, what would you say? Hey, Joe, here's my advice.
First thing you got to do, you got to find like 8 to 10 guys that believe in you. 8 to 10 guys that believe in your system. 8 to 10 guys that can afford it. 8 to 10 guys that can, you know, no matter what you say, they're there. And then from there, hopefully, you know, they start bringing some guys that grows from there. The biggest thing is all these guys that club hop, you know, and then they come back to you and they're like, well, why am I not successful? It's like, you got to stick to a system, you know. You need a system that you stick to and that you trust. And then on the outside, go get your extra training camps and all that good stuff. Like our main thing, we stuck with West Shore Wrestling Club in Burnett through and through. And then, you know, for summer camps, we went to Jeff Jordan's. So we had our two clubs that we would work out with, and then our technique was based off of Jordan.
Nice. Do you love it?
It's awesome.
You love where you're at right now?
It's going good. It's going good. A couple of these guys could give a little bit better fight, but that's all we can ask, man. They're out here competing and doing a good job at a young age. So
nice. And you got a healthy daughter. You're
healthy daughter.
You said she gets all around pretty good in the wrestling
room.
Oh,
yeah. Yep, she's got a knee slide sit out down, so yeah, she's doing well, man. It's a good time.
Nice. Well, dude, I'm pumped up. It's good to see you.
No doubt.
And thanks a lot. I'm glad that your energy is going back into the sport. You got anything else for us, Colin?
That's it, man.
Hey, where do people find your club?
CPWrestling.net.
Thanks,
all the,
man.
All the camps, clubs, all the info's on there.
Awesome. Thanks, Colin.
Thanks, buddy.